Hello viewers, welcome to the ETABS learning tutorial, and today is the tutorial number 4, and today I will analyze a truss and find the reaction of the supports, member force, deflected shape, and I will check my analysis for any one of the joint. So first I would like to open the ETABS. Go to file, new model, and click on no. And then select the unit as key fit. Now I need to input the number of lines in x direction and y direction. See the figure. Here is our truss, and if you will see from the plan, we have only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 point. So I input here as the 9 point. And in y direction, always for frame or truss, the number of line in y direction will be narrow out 1. Now I would like to provide the spacing, and our spacing is 30 feet and all are same. So I select here the uniform spacing as 30, and y direction no need to input. And in case of story data for truss, I will select a story of 50 feet, and then I will draw three reference plane at 30 feet, 40 feet, and 45 feet. So first I need to input the story data as 1, and typical story height is 50 feet, and bottom story is also 50 feet, and then click on the grid only and click on OK. So here is our grid lines for the truss frame, and select on the elevation for my convenience. Okay, next I would like to create the reference plane. First reference plane will for J and P point, that means that is from 30 feet, and next is for 40 feet, and next is for 45. So I go to edit reference planes, and select the unit as feet. So first select the reference plane is as 30, click on add. Next is 40, click on add, and the last is 45, click on add, and then click on OK. So there are some reference planes is created here. Now I need to create the frames, and it is starting from this point. Okay, and select on the draw line object, draw lines, and starting from this point, from here, then here, then here, then here, then here. Just left click of your mouse, and when it is finished, no, it is not finished yet, because I need to go through this line too. Then press enter. Don't worry about the supports, because we will delete the support later. And next, see your model, and it is starting from here. Go to there, then again here. Just click on the frame, click on that point. Again, start for the right side. Be careful while you are creating the model in case of truss, because if you misclick any point, then the truss will be different. Okay, so now select object, just click on this icon to neutralize your cursor. Now see, here is our truss, but we have some unnecessary support is here, and these two supports are different. So I select on this point and this point, and then go to assign joint point or restraint support, and select the fixed, or sorry, maybe one is our ruler and one is our hinge. So I select this support and go to assign joint or point, and go to a restraint or support and select the hinge and click on OK, and it will be hinge. And next left click on that point to provide the ruler support. Go to restraint or support and then select on the ruler and click on OK. And this support is ruler. And next click on the other point where having the support. I would like to nullify the support, just select on that point, go to assign joint or point, and then go to restrain or support and click on this point and click on OK. So see, the support is missing, or they are just hide or deleted. If you'd like to go view and then go to select building view options and hide the grid lines and click on OK. See, this is our truss. And if you'd like to delete the axis, if you can do that from this icon, set building view options, go there and untick the global axis and click on OK. See, this is our truss in a simplest form. And next I need to input the load. Okay, and for this point and this point, this is 5 keep. So I am just click on that point, this point and this point, I need to input a 5 keep load. Okay, go to assign joint or point load, then go to force. Okay, then go to force, and in case of change the force type is as live, load unit is keep fit, and they are vertical load, that means they are global z, because our z axis is here, global z, and load magnitude is -5 because z axis is vertical and upward, but our load direction is downward. So I input here a -5, then click on OK. You can input any type of moment here, click on OK. See, our 5 keep load is assigned. Next I need to input these two load, these are 10 keep load, select these two point, same, go to assign joint or point load force, and they are -10, and click on OK. So the point load is assigned here. And next in the bottom I need to input these two are 20 keep load, this point and this point are 20 keep load, go to assign joint point force -20. And next is next 3 point, this 3 point are 40 keep load. See, this 3 point are 40 keep load. So I select on this 3 point, go to assign and joint or point force, and then click -40, click on OK. 40 keep is assigned, and this 2 is 30. So go to assign joint or point force -30. So this is our model, and this is our truss, and the load are assigned properly. So now I need to run analysis, and it is too much simple. Go to analysis, run analysis, and save it. Since it's our fourth model, I write here fourth model and click on save it. So our model is saved here. So what we would like to see, we would like to see the reactions, member force and deflected shape. First I would like to show you the deflected shape. So in the right window, go to display, show the deformed shape, and select here live static and click on OK. Here is our deflected shape. And if you'd like to see the reaction in the left window, I would like to go display and member force or stress diagram, support or spring reaction, load is a live load, then click on OK, and you will see the reactions. And then most important things, I need to know the member force. Okay, to see the member force, I have to do some extra work. First you need to go the set building view options. Here is an icon, or you can go through view menu, view, set building view options, and then go to in the object view option, select the line level. In the object view options, select the line level and then click on OK. And you will see the line level is here. There is D1, B8. D1 is for the inclined frame, okay? And B8 is for the horizontal frame. So now I will validate for only one point. That means I will check my analysis for A point. And for A point, the resultant of FAB, that means the magnitude of AB and RAY should be equal and opposite is FAJ. So for the FAJ, I find it here. Go to display and then go to show tables, and in the analysis result, select on the analysis tick mark, and in the load cases or combo, just select on the live static load and then click on OK, and then click on OK. Then a table will appear to show you all types of load, and I need to beam force for B8, so click on beam force and select the beam for B8. So the beam force for B8 is 129.76. B8 is this member, that means which is the AB span. So AB span is 129.76. Look, 129.76. And now I need to find out the member force of AJ. In our model, AJ is denoted as D1 bracing. So I select here the bracing force for D1, and the D1 bracing force is -183.57. So our D1 is -183.57, and I need the reaction at A, and our reaction at A is 131.25, and all of the forces are in keep unit. So from the analysis, you can see we have a slight error, which is 0.99 keeps, and we can see and we can tell that our truss analysis is okay. In case of truss analysis, for any one joint, you can check your analysis, and if you find your error is near about 1 or 2 keeps, then you can think your truss analysis is okay. So our truss analysis is okay, and this is the end of my frame or truss analysis tutorial. From the next week, I will upload the video for the building analysis. And if you need to know anything about the frame analysis or truss analysis in ETABS, then please let me know. And if you find this video useful to you, then please subscribe my channel and hit a like and share it. Thank you. Bye bye.